Why you babysitting? Only two or three shots. I'ma show you how to turn it up a notch. First you get a swimming pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. Pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. I wave a few bottles, then I watch them all fly.
Yeah, my first mixtape, we did it in the garage, you know. We just had Pro Tools, you know, a quilt, and a mic stand, and I did about 17 songs, man. I was like 16, and then we threw it out in the city, you know, let it get buzzed in the city, like you said, start from the city first.
Stand up. Pass out.
I felt like I had to start in my own backyard first, you know. I had to secure Compton, because your city don't believe you, the rest of the world won't, you know what I'm saying? And what happened was, I did Compton, then the rest of LA, then that trickled down to the East Coast, you know. And they, everybody else said the East Coast is the hardest people to capture when you're a West Coast artist. And that's exactly what I did. I went out there, sold out SOBs, did a few shows in Brooklyn, and I really touched the people, let them know I'm real. And got me all the way in Paris.
Then I was doing the most that someone said to me. Nigga, why you babysitting? Only two or three shots. I'ma show you.
Dr. Dre, you know, heard me, first time hearing me was on YouTube. You know, a song called Ignorance is Bliss. It was on Kendrick Lamar OD. And he basically reached out to my people as soon as he heard it, you know. Made the connection right then, and we got in the studio the next week. And worked immediately. It's not really slowing down nothing, you know, with Top Dog and Aftermath. Because I still get the, you know, creative, you know, process to, you know, do what I've been doing. I think that's what slows, you know, the artists down when they, you know, not free to do the music they've been making, and they try to change it up, the formula and all this stuff. And yeah, it's been sweet selling, you know, now, and coming close up to the album day, I think it should be cool. Until then, showed and proved myself, you know. Now that I got that date, all the naysayers, they can be quiet now. K-Dot's the neighborhood name, so that'll always be with me forever, you know. My dear friends, my closest homeboys, they always call me K-Dot. It was just, you know, about growth as an artist and, you know, as a person. Where I felt like, you know, an artist with a story, you know, live longer within the music, you know, rather than just a hit record. And once I figured that out, I put the music and the story behind that, and went full force with it, you know, and people feel me, you know, deeper than just one song, you know. They feel the whole lifestyle, you know, and they can relate to it. When I talk about Uncle Bobby, you know, talk about imprisonment, you know, somebody out there, they got the same Uncle Bobby, you know, that's locked up and trying to figure it out, you know what I'm saying? So I know somebody always out there that can, you know, feel it.
Faded.
Definitely, the recipe definitely is the lead song, just for the feel of where, you know, California always been and where it's at today. You know, it's a new sound for sure, you know, but it's still got the same vibe and the same content of just feeling good about yourself when you get out there, you know. All Scoop to Phil producing that joint. Dr. Dre on the vocals, I'm on the vocals, you know, I'm on the hook. Yeah, we just took it to the next level as far as West Coast music, man.
If it do, then you're like me. Make an excuse that your relief is in the bottom of a bottle.
Dre is definitely going to be on the album. He's going to be there. Production, yeah, definitely. Yeah, you have a few tracks. From the Georgia part, it's just, you know, my in-house cast. You know, that's how we wanted to do it. That's how Dre wanted to do it. He really wanted to, you know, broadcast me, you know, as my own entity, you know what I mean? So.
We could drop back off.
That nigga straight, man. That nigga ain't tripping.
We're gonna do the same old shit. I'm gonna pop a few shots. They gonna run opposite way.
It took my whole life to make this album, truthfully. You know, all of, you know, trial and error, all the experiences. You know, not only my experiences, my family experiences, my homeboy. Yeah, up to that date, you know, not just 2010, but yeah, 25 years to come with this, you know. So.
Got them niggas. K-Dot, you good? You good?
Yeah.